would you describe as the purpose of this evening, the 14-hour Technicolor dream?
I think that there's a new period. We're starting a new era. Sweeping around as a kind of reaction to various things that have been happening in the world. And it's it makes itself, manifests itself in love and sweetness and kindness and flowers and, you know, and so we're not initiating anything so much as portraying what is happening.
What emotionally do you expect to do for everybody here tonight?
It's just some, in a way, a kind of giant communion in a way. I don't know what out of the event itself we expect to get, other than people meeting each other and talking to each other and touching each other.
Why the emphasis on touching all the time?
Words are not effective, but the best way to finally bring about any kind of human contact is actually physically to touch someone.
Would you say that you were, as the Californian people do, would you say that you were beautiful people?
Oh, I think so. I think people are concerned with beauty and colors and flowers and nature, and I think there is a kind of aesthetic sense about the whole movement.
What, for instance, is beautiful about you?
What's beautiful about me? I don't know. I'm very loving and very giving, and I don't know. I think that's beautiful. I'm not jealous or possessive, I'm very tolerant of people and time. And, I don't know, I think that's a beautiful trait.
Do you think more and more people will come to feel the way that you do?
Oh, I hope so, yes. I think that it's in the air right now. I mean, for example, 5 years ago, if a policeman came up and harassed a group of people, he would receive mutterings and complaints from the group. Now, if a policeman harasses, say, a group who are considered spiritually a part of the underground, they would probably give them flowers or be sympathetic to the man's job.
The organizers of this country's first major psychedelic event chose May Day Eve for their all-night ritual and Alexandra Palace as their temple. They offered the Queen and the Prime Minister free admission and charged 7,000 other people a pound a head. Performers, like the Exploding Galaxy Ballet Company, gave their services free. This work, extemporized for the event, is called the Fuzz Death Ballet. In the language of the underground, the words of groovy people, fuzz means authority, especially the police. The aim of this country's first ever be-in was to raise funds for the movement's newspaper, which faces the threat of an obscene publication prosecution. They provided 20 beat and pop groups, 12 new wave poets, concerts of projected colored lights moving in psychedelic synchronization to the music, green candy floss, mountains of bananas, and for many of us, the first sight and sound of their message of love, the language of mellow yellow, the art of the happening. Call the poetry, the music, the patterns, sculpture and films, the whole artistic output of the beautiful people, the work of the underground. Psychedelic is their favorite word. It means increased perception. It also means what happens when you take LSD and other drugs.
of your dancing were those rings on your legs and in your underpants?
Well, some of them I got them from an American, South American Indian tribe. The circles mean, you know, the exits and entrances of the soul, of the spirit. And the stripes mean that these are the boundaries between the material and the immaterial.
Do you think you got your message across?
I think so. I think a lot of people understood that. Incidentally, we only started forming this company last Tuesday. We had no rehearsal whatsoever. It was completely a free expression thing, and we intend to play in the streets of London, and we have a dive-in ballet in the Thames. You know, we're trying to construct our own homemade submarine, and we hope to do that in summertime.
I want to know why you came here.
Oh, you do?
Well, we came here because for joy.
For what?
Fun.
Joy. Fun.
What kind of joy?
Anything where people don't have to walk in step like everybody else. Where people can feel free to enjoy themselves and let your hair down. In short, where they can be children again.
Do you think that's a better kind of joy than the kind that is ordinarily available?
Well, say I want to jump around like a crazy fool. Well, in most places, people would say, oh, he's making a fool of himself, or he's an exhibitionist. But obviously, many of us must be in mental homes for the simple reason that we can't let ourselves go. If people could only scream whenever they felt like screaming, or laugh like mad when they felt like laughing, I feel that lots of us would be sane, and people wouldn't resort to violence.
Traditionally a pagan festival celebrating fertility, which was why, said the organizers, this piece was called A Pretty Girl Is Like a Manifesto. It seems any number can play this new form of artistic Russian roulette. All you need is a pair of scissors, a pretty girl, and enough volunteers to snip off her clothing piece by piece.
Relaxation has been funny. Some people take it too seriously.
Yeah.
Chelsea. You're not the kind of typical person one would expect to see here.
Well, actually, I live in Chelsea, and as you know, every shop in the King's Road that's not an antique shop is a boutique, and they're all advertising there, so I couldn't help but be aware of it. And then I'm a bookseller, and as you know, in San Francisco, where these things started, a good deal of poetry has come out of it. Whether you think it's good poetry or not, remains to be seen. And had you, so to speak, been in Paris at the time you used Lautrec, it would have been interesting to go and see what he was painting. And this could be the compost out of which some interesting artistic achievement could come. I think the audience is much better than show. It's the audience which is the interesting part, and the audience which somebody might paint or somebody might write about.
What do you think a happening means?
Well, last Saturday, I went in the bathroom to clean my teeth, and I looked in the mirror and I said, I'll have a shave. So I shaved right up to there, you know.
Why did you do that?
I suppose, you know, I don't know. I just thought, you know, I'll shave up to there, you know. And so it was sort of happening.
Let's have a look at the back of it.
Well, there's a few scabs there.
Why did you stop there?
So I couldn't do the back myself. And this girl from downstairs, she did the back for me, you know. And
why did you leave the bit on top?
Because I ran out of razor blades, you know.
Yeah, some nights it isn't, you know, but tonight, I don't know why, it just has been. It's fabulous.
It's like being born in the sea, and the waves are washing over you, and it's creating patterns of light.
But then, you don't know what it's like to be born out of the sea.
Yeah. But I can imagine it. That's the whole scene. You know, this is like, it's just using your imagination. That's what you let go. That's what you can't let go because you're working.
So I agree.
We're letting our imagination flow with the rhythm of the music, and that's like the rhythm of the sea, or it's like the rhythm of creation. Here you have reason and instinct, and there's a continuum between those two, and that's, you know, it's like conducting an orchestra. You're the conductor, you're there, and that's it.
Do you know what the evening's really all about? Do you think that's
no, I don't think anybody does.
Perhaps we don't understand.
You can't understand if it's not explained. I mean, algebra is actually a mystery until somebody teaches it. And the trouble is with these people, they're all quoting words, but they don't know what they mean.
How do you feel towards all these people, then?
I feel rather sorry for them, personally.
What?
I think, well, to me, they're looking for something, but they don't even know themselves what they're looking for. They've come here, every one of them, a number of people have come up to me, where's the rave, where's the do? And I see the same people an half an hour later and they're just wandering aimlessly about.
Mr. Marowitz, you're the man who in fact introduced a happening into the Edinburgh Festival. If you were asked to explain to most of the middle-aged parents of the young people here tonight what this event meant, what would you tell them?
Well, I think I would say that it was a calculated attempt to try to avoid the kind of discipline and squareness that their own lives represented to these younger people. And I think from that standpoint, it's admirable.
Thank you.
wonder if I could wake you up for a moment. Why are you asleep? You what? Did you come here to sleep?
Trying to find out what it was all like.
What did you expect to get out of it?
Just find out what it was like, and what the interpretation of this psychedelic happening was like. Otherwise, nothing, I don't think.
There were seldom less than three groups playing at once during the 14-hour Technicolor Dream, and after 9 hours they queued on a beat group called The Flies, accompanied by girls called the Vestal Virgins. They played in the dawn. A poetry recital by a new wave poet, a member of the underground.
What kind of market is there for your poetry?
Well, I mean, last week I read at the Palmer's Green National Assistance, and I read a sound poem, and the whole of the National Assistance joined in, you know, which is what I wanted, audience participation. And, you know, the National Assistance manager came out and said, you know, unless they shut up, they wouldn't get any money, you know, we'll be thrown out. You know.
What did you think of this evening?
I thought it was marvellous, you know, I mean, especially as I was on a trip.
What do you mean on a trip?
Acid.
How do you mean?
LSD.
My name is Susie Creamcheese.
What do you do for a living?
Well, sometimes I dance for a living. Sometimes I run switchboards. Sometimes I work with sick children. Sometimes I just live.
How would you describe yourself?
I wouldn't.
I've been told you're a West Coast hipster from way back. Now, what does that mean?
That's somebody else's words.
Why didn't we get your act this evening?
Because I don't have an act. Because in something like this, all you can do is dig it. You just go where it's going and flow with it.
What does that mean?
Do it, live it. It's all here, man. There are God knows how many thousands of beautiful people digging it. Don't take pictures of me, take pictures of them.
What can come out of it?
Beautiful people. Beautiful children are growing up in the hills of San Francisco that are, who are just so free and so loving. Beautiful minds, loving children, absolutely free, loving children. Those are the children who may get a chance to grow up and to have a loving world. Maybe it'll be three generations from now. But we can fight our middle-class backgrounds or whatever it is that we're fighting. And we can try to give something prettier to our children. And give something prettier to the world that's so bloody worried about everything.
Prettier than war?
Prettier than wars and blood and death and income tax.
To 15 years ago, we might have described the way out people of those days as teddy boys. Boys like these might have been teddy boys, but in this groovy climate, they might well be today's squares.
Now, what do you think of this evening's entertainment?
Well, I ran it bloody mad myself.
Why is that?
I go around chucking all these flower bombs about. It's not worth it. You get all your clothes mucked up and everything, and they're all mad. They're just mad. What do they get out of it? Not any life in it, no good enjoyment. They must be
touching.
They want to go in a loony bin.
Why do you think they do it?
Well, I think they do it. Christ knows, it's beyond me.
Did you come here to enjoy yourself this evening?
Yeah, no, I haven't.
What did you expect?
Something better than this.
What sort of thing?
Well, a good laugh and that. It's no good going jumping around and throwing flower bombs and all that blinking tubular lot with all the blinking full of it. I like a good laugh and joke, drink, you know, and the girls, decent girls, not all this blinking club that they wear.
Yeah. You don't fancy the girls we're here this evening?
Oh, they're all right, but look at the state of them, the clothes they wear, I mean.
What's wrong with them?
Well, what's right with them?
Why don't you tell me what's wrong with them?
Well, you take it, blinking long dresses down their ankles.
What?
All these long dresses and baggy drawers they wear.
I detect a hint of jealousy over there.
They do.
And half the blokes are walking around here. They all need a blinking good bath.
They need them.
It's been a success.
Yes, I think it has been a great success because, like, the people who came here have been really turned on by what's happened here. And they've gone away saying, what a beautiful thing, we must have more like this.
Who's been turned on?
I've been turned on by the beautiful people here. because everybody's so nice, so much out to enjoy themselves. And
what exactly does turned on mean? Are you turned on at the moment?
My senses have been drenched.
Your what?
Senses have been drenched.
What lie and how?
It's more
it's the atmosphere.
The whole thing here,
yes.
You know, like, that's the idea of something like this, that it really does drench your senses to be up all night dancing about, bombarded by sound and by light, and by anything else you want to be bombarded by that they can provide here.